What's up YouTube, zombiekiller here, doing a quick video as an update to my channel. A little bit ago I made an update video talking about random mysterious series which I gave hints towards about what I was going to do, which I tried to see if anybody would try to guess it. Nobody bothered to try, so I'm just gonna flat out announce it either way, but now here's the announcement. Yes, the series is Kingdom Hearts. There's a total of 9 different ones that are out currently for PS4. And I'm gonna be covering all 9 of them in the Let's Play video series, plus also just a watching video series for some of them. But anyways, because they don't actually allow gameplay. But anyways, so I will be focusing on doing that. And hopefully you guys will enjoy. If possible, when I'm done, I'm gonna try to see if I could just upload the videos of the in-game cutscenes. Some games may not have that feature. I think they all do, but just in case if some don't, don't be surprised if it don't get done, but I'm gonna try to do that. I will be playing the game to completion. Not 100% completion, but to completion. So that means, for example, in Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, you play as Tira, the girl with the blue hair. Aqua, the girl with the blue hair, Tira, the boy with the brown hair, and Ventus, which is the one with the white hair. You probably will learn more about them as I play that series. But anyways, each one of them had their own separate campaign. I will be playing through all of those campaigns. Not just playing one and done. And as far as Kingdom Hearts Rechain Memory, that have a two-sided campaign. There's Sora campaign, which is the guy with the brown here, there, and then there's Riku, which is, if you look on the right side, the second one up, you know, you'll see a girl on the top, right side top, you'll see a girl in a picture, and then a guy with silver hair, that's Riku. I will be playing through as Riku too, because they have different branching stories. But other than that, most of it is just a one-time play. I will not be worried about getting every challenge 100% complete or be all optional bosses. Because I won't lie to you, some of those optional bosses can be very tough. And some of those optional missions can be very tough to do. And this game, if you really want to try to platinum all 9 of these games, you could probably spend at least 700 to 900 hours, give or take, trying to get the platinum trophy. I'm not gonna be doing that. I might give it a try in the far future, but I don't think I'm gonna be doing it as a video series, because some of these optional bosses are extremely dangerous. Now, that does not mean I'm gonna 100% avoid every optional boss. I might do a few just for fun. But that doesn't mean I'm going to go out of my way to try to kill them all, either. I will not guarantee what percent completion I will get, but I will, at the very least, complete all the main story. With Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2, there is a Winnie the Pooh world. I might complete that, or I might mostly complete it, who knows. It's more optional side missions, to be honest, not important world, but I'll probably try to complete it. But if I'm not mistaken, I gotta find pages and stuff, which I may not find them all. So, Winnie the Pooh might be 100% complete, might not. Anyways, even though in 1 and 2, spoilers, the Little Mermaid world, that's technically considered optional. You can kind of get through the game without beating them at both worlds, but I'm still gonna play through them. But I've been doing quite a bit of research with Birth by Sleep and to try to get a better idea of what order would probably be the best to help you guys understand the story. And by far as I could see, which, you know, we both by sleep, I end up playing this order anyways, so it did not matter. But most people suggest doing Terra, the guy with the brown hair, Ventus, the guy with the blue hair, yellow hair, sorry. And then Aqua, the girl with the blue hair down below. So I will be playing through them in that exact order. Now, originally, Kingdom Hearts was released with Kingdom Hearts 1, Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memory, Kingdom Hearts 2, Kingdom Hearts 358/2 days, Kingdom Hearts Recoded, then Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep. I'm not going to play in that order, because the release order is going to be what makes so many people think that this game is confusing. I'm going to be playing in proper story mode order. And I'm talking about where the story ends order. Because technically, these two had the same timeline for the story. In fact, Kingdom Hearts 358/2 days actually starts before Chain of Memories, but ends after it. So I'm going to do that one after Chain of Memory. But how I'm going to be doing it is Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep in the exact order that I said I would play it. Kingdom Hearts 1, Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memory, Kingdom Hearts 358 Days, Kingdom Hearts 2, and then Kingdom Hearts Recoded. And then as far as the content on 2.8, I will do Dream Drop Distance next, then Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep, and then I will be doing the Kingdom Hearts X, I think, what was it called? Oh well, anyways, I forgot the name of it. Anyways, I haven't even started that at all. I heard by doing research that it's supposed to be taking place before Birth by Sleep, but it's not that big of a deal because it's not going to impact the immediate story. I'm more worried about getting the immediate story out because I heard that it's supposed to be at least 100 years in the past before Birth by Sleep even happened, so I'm just going to skip that one and leave that one as the final one. I think it's Black Cover, actually. Kingdom Hearts X Black Cover. I will be saving that one for very last, because it's the farthest back. Now, Kingdom Hearts 1 goes over like all the basic stuff, and then they don't really worry about sharing it. But I will be going over all the basic information that's vital in Birth by Sleep. And also, I recommend, after watching the series, give it a rewatch, so that way you can fully understand it. You know, watch every series once, and then watch it all again. You'll come to know the story good. Kingdom Hearts have a very big story, which a lot of people think is super complex, because they play all out of order, and they don't try to redo stuff. But I have a pretty good grasp on the Kingdom Hearts story. In fact, Kingdom Hearts is one of my most favorite gaming franchise series. And hopefully, later this year, Kingdom Hearts 3 was announced to come out later this year. But hopefully it doesn't get pushed back again. If it does come out this year, then I will be hopefully getting that and covering that too. And as long as you watch all of these plus that, you'll have a full grasp of Kingdom Hearts knowledge. Now, I might do, like, informational videos if you guys got any questions about these games, but we'll see what happens. But, like I said, I'm playing with Birth by Sleep first, Kingdom Hearts 1, Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memory, Kingdom Hearts 365 Days, Kingdom Hearts 2, and then Kingdom Hearts Recoded. Then it's going to be Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, then Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep, then Kingdom Hearts X Black Cover. And Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance. I only got a Let's Play up. Well, I got quite a bit of episodes. I never finished the game yet with that Let's Play. I'm still towards the beginning. But I will probably, more than likely, continue from where I left off on that. I might start all over, but I'm pretty sure, like 90% sure, when the time comes to it, when I get to the game, I'm going to probably continue from there, so feel free to watch that if you want. And if you got a good grasp of the Kingdom Hearts lore, you know, it would not really mess up too much your understanding. You could probably hop in it and be alright. I will, for the most part, try to go over some basic information for Birth by Sleep, just to cover some stuff, because there is a weapon called the Keyblade, which is pretty much a magical sword, more in simplest terms, which the first game really cover over. But it has multiple capabilities and stuff. The first game really covers it, and Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep don't really cover it too much, because it expects you to almost know it, but that's going to be the only one that will be coming before the original, so it will be fine. And then if you play Kingdom Hearts 1 and then hop straight to Kingdom Hearts 2 and not play these two, you'll be like, what just happened? Because you'll just lose all the plot points. All these games are connected to each other in a mixed smash timeline. And you gotta know the proper timeline to properly get the story. Release dates of the game is not the proper timeline. But all of them joined together for a good story. And it's Disney and Final Fantasy. You just can't go wrong with that. I love the opening songs from these games too. I will catch myself actually looking up that song on YouTube and just listening to it hours while I'm playing other games. That plus the song from Persona 5, Never See It Coming. I just listen to those two songs a lot while I'm playing other games, just grinding. And, you know, I'm not one of those people that go super crazy about, oh, this soundtrack's awesome, this soundtrack is okay, this one, you know, wasn't as good as I want. But I will admit it, Kingdom Hearts have amazing soundtrack, just like Persona 5. I catch myself listening to those two. The Kingdom Hearts franchise, I am 100% in love with. I have every Kingdom Hearts game for the PS3 and the PS4. That's how much I loved it. I still got Kingdom Hearts 1, 2, and Rechain Memory for the old PS2 days. But, yeah, 365 Day was on like 3DS, Birth by Sleep I still got for PSP, and Recoded was on, Dream Drop Distance 3DS. Anyways, they've been on multiple different systems. Point is, I still got all these for my PS3 and PS4 mainly. Is the most point. But yeah, they're all good. This is an amazing franchise. I recommend that you guys join me, watch, learn more about the Kingdom Hearts lore. Now, who knows if I'll get to fighting all the optional bosses, because to be honest, if you truly go dedicated into these games, you could get well over 100 hours worth of gameplay in one. And then if you're going like extremely dedicated, just trying to collect every trophy, you could probably get over 200 hours easily in these games. There's a lot of content for these games. But anyways, now I can't say nothing about Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep and Kingdom Hearts Kingdom Hearts X Cover Black or something, Black Cover, whatever they call it. I haven't really checked it out too much, so and then Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, I can't really say much about them, because to be honest, I only played a little bit of Dream Drop Distance. and I was kind of distracted trying to complete other projects, but that's why I watched to get all my other projects done that I've been working on, so that way I can just dedicate my full time to Kingdom Hearts. So you'll probably see nothing but Kingdom Hearts on my channel for probably a month or two, give or take how long it takes me to beat all these. Might be less, might be more, but I'm gonna be mainly trying to focus on getting all these complete before I move on to another video series. And if requested, I might even try doing all these on harder difficulty modes. I'm just gonna go for like the easiest difficulty mode just to make gameplay quicker and stuff for you guys. But if you guys want, if this franchise does seem like you guys are interested, you guys can request stuff. Watching speedruns, I will try to speedrun these if you guys want. Watching me play on higher difficulties, watching me try to pull my hair out while I try to complete every last content in the game, which is insane, let's be honest. You get a ridiculous amount. But anyways, you know, all that good stuff. I'm definitely, though, am not looking forward to playing as Ventus. He have a required minigame. That thing took me 2 hours just to beat, because you gotta get a perfect score just to continue on with the mission. That took me over 2 hours of grinding on it just to beat that. Yeah, his mission's kind of insane. That random challenge mission when you're going for perfect score. But anyways, if you guys like these, let me know. I will do videos. If you guys want to learn information about these games, let me know. I'll do videos. Like Kingdom Hearts 1 has some interesting features that can set you up for the game, which I will probably be covering over basic information like that in the Let's Play. But you know, there's lots to these games. There's a whole bunch of depth. If you go straight up, you know, learning everything that the game has, all the information, you could get probably well over 1,000 hours if you try to memorize all that and learn all that and all that stuff. There's a lot to Kingdom Hearts. It's not just some half-baked franchise. It's actually a good, in-depth, time devotion type franchise, which is one thing I like. And yes, the clock measures your time in hours. That's how long it expects you to play these games. Now yes, you might be able to speedrun and probably find some stuff, which if you guys are interested in speedruns, I will do them. But first, I will probably end up focusing on beating all these before I do request. But do, at any time that you want to see content for this, write it down. I will make a note about it, and after I'm done with all these series and Let's Play, I will start from any request for these series. And as soon as I notice your request, I'll even do a shout out in a video about it. Be like, oh, this person here commented they want to see Kingdom Hearts 1 beat, speed 1. Alright, so I will be focusing on that later once I beat all these. So stay tuned and I will do that pretty much type of thing. But yeah, Kingdom Hearts franchise, good franchise. I will be playing all them. Once again, I will go from Birth by Sleep, Kingdom Hearts 1, Kingdom Hearts 3 Chain of Memory, Kingdom Hearts 358 Days, well, / 2 days, Kingdom Hearts 2, Kingdom Hearts Recoded, Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, Kingdom Hearts 0.2, Birth by Sleep, and Kingdom Hearts the X Black Cover, which the X I believe is key given Kingdom Hearts 2 lore. But anyways, I will be going over all of that. And then who knows, maybe Kingdom Hearts 3 will come out later this year. If I'm able to, I'm going to get my hands on it and I'm going to cover that game too. But, you know, as far as it goes from Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, but 0.2, but by sleep, and Kingdom Hearts X Black Cover, I haven't really got a chance to play those. So I don't know the full lore for them. I've been kind of busy with all the other franchises, trying to get them out. So, this is what's going to be mostly on my channel. Hopefully you guys enjoy. And like I said, I'm going to try to get all the cutscenes uploaded, especially if it does have cutscenes. If not, I might have to do some video tweaking to allow the cutscenes, maybe. But I think they should all have cutscenes capabilities. And yes, this was made by Disney and Square Enix. And yes, they did do a good job. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed. And I think you like the soundtracks for these games too. It got a good soundtrack. I love the music for Kingdom Hearts, especially the opening song. Amazing. That's what I find myself playing and listening to. But anyways, I'll see you guys on those videos. They should be out soon, and it's gonna probably be quite a bit of hours with the gameplay for each one. It's not gonna be like a 5-6 episodes done. I might be able to do a speedrunning, because if you speedrun a game, you can kind of beat it kind of ridiculously quick. But still, I don't even think you could beat it that quick even with a speedrun. And by the way, when I do speedruns, I try not to abuse glitches, so they're actually legit speedruns. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoy these franchises. If you like Kingdom Hearts and want to see more content, let me know. Any content that you guys want to see, message for it on my channel, and I will probably go over that content. And as far as Kingdom Hearts go, after I beat all these games, I am up for it. Pretty much any content that you guys requested during the video series. Alright, so I will see you guys on those videos. Alright, and hopefully you guys enjoy.